It's time for Tiger Talk on the Tiger Sports Network. Tiger Talk, live from Big Smoke Barbecue on the corner of 8th and Main in Hayes. A distinctly local take on classic American barbecue. Order online at BigSmokeHayes.com. Tiger Talk is also brought to you by these premier Tiger sponsors. Golden Belt Bank of Hayes and Ellis. Banking one story at a time. The Hayes Med Orthopedic Institute. Expertise, technology, compassion, all right here. Adams Brown, Strategic Allies and CPAs. Going above plus beyond for you. BTI, your John Deere dealer in Buckland, Great Bend, Greensburg, Hoxie, Mess City, and Pratt. BTI, our family in partnership with your family. The Taco Shop. Dine in, carry out, or delivery. You've never had it so good. And Eagle Communications, our community connected. Now, the voice of the Tigers, Gerard Welbrock.
And a good afternoon and welcome to Tiger Talk. We're live at Big Smoke Barbecue at the corner of 8th and Main in Hayes. We'll be talking some Fort Hayes State basketball. Women's head coach Tony Hobson will join us here in just a few minutes. Men's coach Mark Johnson for the last half hour of the program. Certainly glad to have you a part of it. And we'll get you set for another week of Fort Hayes State basketball. Down to 2 weeks left in the regular season. Then it's on to the conference postseason tournament. The Tiger men and women wrapping up the home slate this past week. Thursday night, taking on the Blue Tigers of Lincoln. Then Saturday afternoon, the Mules and Jennies of Central Missouri were in town. We'll recap those games and preview this week. Tigers on the road. They'll be in Pittsburgh on Thursday, taking on the Gorilla Men and Women, 5:30 and 7:30. And then Saturday afternoon in Joplin to tangle with Missouri Southern. Again, we're live at Big Smoke Barbecue in Hayes here at 8th and Main. Stop on by. Open Monday through Saturdays, 11 to 8 for lunch and dinner. It's the old soda shop locations. You get all the soda shop and soda fountain drinks, but of course the best barbecue around. They've got their own dry rub and their special sauces, a lot to choose from. And if you can't come on by, you want to take some home tonight for supper, BigSmokeHayes.com. That's where you put in your to-go order and swing on by on your way home from work at Big Smoke Barbecue, corner of 8th and Main in Hayes. We want to remind you, you can participate of the program. If you have a question for the coaches, you can go to the Fort Hayes State Athletics website, FHSUathletics.com. Click on fans. You'll get that drop-down menu, and then on the very bottom, you'll see Ask the Coach. Submit your question, and if we use it, you'll be in the running for a $25 gift certificate from Big Smoke Barbecue here in Hayes. We'll give that away at the end of the month. And again, we'll remind you, you can tune into our Tiger broadcast while watching on the MIAA TV network. You can listen to our radio play-by-play with the TV feed, especially when the Tigers are on the road. All you have to do is download the TuneIn app and search Mix 103 KJLS. Make that a favorite. And then on game day, when you're watching the game, whichever device is ahead, either the audio or the video, you'll pause it right before tip-off, and then when the other catches up, unpause, and you can listen to the game, sync it up, hear our radio play-by-play with the MIAA TV network feed. Joined now by the head women's coach at Fort Hays State, Tony Hobson. Tigers coming off a split, had a win over Lincoln, and then it's a tough one to Central Missouri, just a hard-fought battle but two really good teams going at it, and unfortunately for Fort Hays State, the Jennies come away with the victory on Saturday, and you know, I guess it's one of those mixed results. You took care of business on Thursday, did what you had to do, and you look at Saturday, I mean, minus free throws and a little bit of rebounding issue. I thought you played really, really well. Just those little things. When you're playing a team of that caliber, those little things come up and become really big things. But I thought you played well both games, quite honestly.
Well, I liked our effort. We were definitely prepared, and the kids were, I thought, mentally ready to play both games. And you know, the Central Missouri, we'll go in reverse.
That works for me.
You know, you, like you said, when you're in tight games like that, you just have to make the plays down the end. And in this case, we had some critical free throws missed when wouldn't have put us ahead. But, you know, Megan had a couple there when we were down three. Katie's an 82% free throw shooter. She goes 4 for 8. That's uncharacteristic for her. Liv missed a couple. You can't leave those points points out there against them. They're just too good, and they execute really well down the stretch. They have a couple go-to players. So in tight games, and that's the difference. When you win a lot of tight games, you usually have some kids there at the end that can make plays or make shots and take care of the ball. And they have a good solid point guard that can get her own shot, and then their four man is really good. So I thought we played, executed pretty well. We didn't get it into the post as much as I wanted to. I thought we missed some opportunities mm-hmm. there. I thought we were open all night in there. Got it in there a good portion, but not as much. So I thought our posts were pretty effective when they got the ball. Jesse had a good ball game, and Katie was scoring inside, had 8 assists, and played really well. So, you know, I don't think it was a matter of our kids not being ready and not playing hard. It just we just didn't quite make enough plays, which has been, you know, kind of the theme. We've had nine games that are either 2 points or 1 point games mm-hmm. this year, and we've won 3 and we've lost 6. And you know, we haven't lost all of them, but we need to win those tight ones. And if you flip that over, then we're in good shape.
Yeah.
But you don't. You just go back to you don't go back to the drawing board this time of year. You just go back to get ready and go after it again, because we have some tough ball games coming up.
You know, it's kind of ironic just looking at it with the free throw shooting, because you shot the ball really well, especially against mm-hmm. them. I mean, you're right at 49%, but 4 of 11 from 3. You'll take that most about every time out there. You shot the ball better than you've been all year, and then it's kind of ironic that it's the free throw shooting in a game that you're shooting it so well comes back to bite you a little bit.
Yeah, there's just no correlation there, you know, and I've had games before where you can't make a layup, but you're 21 out of 24 from the line. You know, it's just, it doesn't make any sense. It's a funny game sometimes, and I swear sometimes that ball is not round. it was unfortunate that I thought we played hard enough to win it. Just didn't quite get it done.
You know, and you know, they had that run right before the end of the first half, got that lead, got it up to, what, 11 a couple of times. It was even 11 late in the third. And, again, your team, as we've seen so many times, just kept battling, kept grinding, and had a chance. You said you had a chance to cut it to 1, but did not go away, didn't expect them to, and just kind of showed their heart and their battle in that contest.
Well, I mean, our kids have shown time and time again that, you know, there's not quit in them. They're not going to do that. We just go too long sometimes in those when we're giving up some points. We just have too much of a drought scoring wise, and you just you can't do that. And part of that is, you know, you might execute really well, get it inside, get fouled instead of getting the layup. You get fouled and miss a free throw, maybe miss one of them, mm-hmm. maybe miss both. And that's kind of what leads. It just stacks on each other like that. So then you get down 11 and you play great for 4 or 5 minutes to get it back to 3. You know, where, man, if you just could have kept it to 4 or 5, then you'd be playing from the lead, and that's a totally different ballgame.
Well, Katie, she had a heck of a game. You look at her line, 16, 7 rebounds, 9 assists, a career high for her, played 37 minutes, but she did everything she could. And yet a lot of them were leaving it on the floor and left it all out there. But that was as gritty of an effort against a really good team, and she was going up against a really good player in Littrell quite a bit. So that was a heck of an effort by her.
Well, she was matched up defensively trying to for most of the game, mm-hmm. not all the game, but for most of the game. She's guarding one of the best players in the conference, so we're asking her to do that. We also were running a lot of the offense through her, which was a planned thing, and letting her initiate the offense. So, you know, I mean, Katie, she's shown time and time again. She'll go down in our history as being one of the best players to ever play at Fort Hays State before it's all said and done. And she is just a super competitor and plays one way, and that is full bore the whole time. And she's holding us in there a lot of games just because she's tough and she can do a lot of things. So didn't want to play her 37 minutes, but you know, she's capable of doing that because she can play through a little fatigue.
Unfortunately for Olivia, it's two games in a row. She got to play a little more on Saturday, but got in foul trouble again, and that just makes it tough because, as you said, it's an area I think you can exploit them. But when and she had that was the same scenario when you played them on New Year's Eve at their place. Just unfortunately can't exploit it when she's sitting on the bench by you.
Yeah. Well, the first one, you know, she got a bad one called on her. Mm-hmm. You know, Central Missouri's really good at running their guards in the backside and moving under you and flopping every time and they get one a game that isn't a correct call and sometimes our officials aren't good enough to see the difference, you know, and as I watch film and
yeah.
That statement is correct.
I watched it yesterday as well.
Yes.
You concur.
So, you know, I don't fault the other team. I mean, if that's the way it's going to be called, where you can just as somebody stretched out going up for the ball, where you can just run underneath them and fall down, and they're going to give you the call, I'd do it too. But they're good at that, and so she got one kind of cheapy call, and then. You know, she's going to naturally get some because she tries to block a lot of shots. But she does seem to kind of be snake-bitten against Central Missouri as far as getting in foul trouble. And she played 10 minutes the first time, 14. You know, she got about one game worth in two. So, and I don't know. Did she get three shots?
She went three for three.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Luckily, the thing that kept us in the game is that Jesse had a really good game off the bench. If she doesn't come in and really produce offensively, then we're in trouble. Mm-hmm. But she did a good job. But we would have liked to had Liv in there a little longer.
No doubt about that. Tigers come up short, but they got a nice win on Thursday. We'll talk about Lincoln. We'll also preview what's ahead. Big week, big stretch here the next 2 weeks. In fact, Fort A State facing a lot of conference contenders starting on Thursday night in Pittsburgh. Tiger Talk today brought to you by Golden Belt Bank. Your life has a story. Golden Belt Bank would like to get to know that story. It's banking one story at a time. Visit them online, goldenbeltbank.com. We've got more Tiger Talk from Big Smoke Barbecue right after the break here on the Tiger Sports Network built by PwC. Grabbed by Levy, lead pass, Ruddle catches and lays it in at the horn. What a pass from Levy from three quarters court. She's got three of the best assists of the year. The basket counts, 25-8. That was the final bucket of the first quarter on Thursday night. Fort A State women knocking off the Lincoln Blue Tigers, 77-57. Welcome back to Tiger Talk live at Big Smoke Barbecue in Hayes, corner of 8th and Main in downtown Hayes. If you can't join us for lunch, get it to go for supper tonight. BigSmokeHayes.com. Gerard Welbrock, head women's coach Tony Hobson. Tigers a split at home. And, we heard that highlight right before the first half. Great job by Emma to beat the buzzer. Great pass from Levy. And I do. I mean, I think her three assists in that first quarter were unbelievable. A couple of them, I think her second one, I made the comment, Patrick Mahomes hopes he throws a pass that well. Because, I mean, it was like a quarterback throwing. The receiver hadn't even broken the route yet and catching. It was a layup, I think, for Katie. That was fun to watch.
Well, Brooke is – she's really talented passing the ball. And she's kind of, you know, we were talking a few weeks ago about the freshman kind of hitting a little bit of a, you know, they're normal after 20 games. They're not used to this long a season. But she's, you know, she's starting to perk up again. And she's playing much better the last few games. And really on Saturday she played fine against Central Missouri. But Thursday, you know, you could see her. Kind of settling in, and she's a good passer and a pass first person, and if we can just have people run the floor, she will find them. So I'm happy to see her kind of start playing better, so we'll use her more for sure.
Well, Sydney puts in a lot of minutes. She's logged a lot. That'll be nice to give her just a little bit of breather. And you know, kudos to your team. You had Central Missouri lurking on Saturday. We knew the importance of that game, but they came out, played well, jumped out to a 12-2 lead over Lincoln, had that 25-8 lead, and just kind of maintained it the rest of the day, which is, hey, that was fine. And you go look at what Lincoln did. They gave Kearney all they wanted on Saturday. That was a big win. Lincoln has 7 playing right now, but they're playing hard. You got to give them credit. They're, you know, some of those maybe addition by subtraction, but they're playing for good basketball.
Well, that's exactly what's happened to them is they've lost a couple to injury and then a couple to other things. And it's one of those things where the kids that are left there are the ones that have been engaged, and there's no fluff on that team. There's 7 kids. They're all going to play. They play hard, and they're actually playing better right now than they have all year. So, you know, you have to give them credit. But you see a team with 7 kids out there warming up, and you think, well, this is going to be easy. Well, you know, if it's the wrong 7, they can be pretty tough. They're just really athletic, and it's one of those games where you're absolutely right about being easy to overlook them, thinking that it's going to be not a tough game and all of those things. But I thought we focused on what we needed to on Thursday, took care of our business, and got ready for Central Missouri. But it would have been easy to not do that. But our kids understand this time of the year that you just have to really make sure you don't let somebody slip up on us. You know, we've lost 8 games, and I looked. We haven't gotten beat by somebody underneath us, or somebody with a very bad record, a bad record at all. Because I think the 8 teams that have beaten us have a combined record of 167-33.
I believe
so. That's, you know, if you spread that out over, it's basically 21-4 at this time of year. So. We've been in all those games, except probably Pitt. So, you know, you just have to hope that a little good fortune strikes you at the right time. But I really liked our mental focus and preparedness for that Thursday game.
Well, as it turned out, you held them to 3 of 16 shooting from beyond the arc, and they hit their threes against Kearney. I mean, it's easy to look back now, but that's probably one of the keys to that game. You did not let them get comfortable, because they proved when they do get comfortable, they're going to be tough to beat, and Kearney had all they wanted.
Well, I know they have number 3 is a really good 3-point shooter. Don't know her name.
Kelsey Mitchell.
I'm not good with names, but I'm really good with numbers. But, you know, she had, I think, 5 against us at Lincoln, so we did a good job of covering her up and just making the other kids shoot them a little quicker than normal. So, you have to be able to play their drive, but boy, if they're hitting their threes, then you got a pretty tough assignment if you're guarding on the perimeter.
Yeah, they attack as well as anybody, and they're so quick and athletic, as you said. You know, and that's the key to them, keep them in front of you, but that's easier said than done.
Well, you can't hardly see them. They're, you know, 5'2", 5'3", and then the tall guard that's 5'5", she weighs 90. I mean, she can get through some really small spots going to the basket. You know, it's hard to keep them in front, and they're super quick, and all of them are tough kids. You know, they can hit the deck and get back up and just keep moving, and none of them get tired. I mean, they all can all run all day. So just an active crew that you know, you have to respect a group like that hangs in there and plays as hard as they do when they have the record they do, and they're giving people some fits.
Yeah, Katie was big again, 16 rebounds, one off her career high, and that was really the key. You owned the glass, you dominated the glass, you didn't give them second opportunities, and she was a big reason why.
Yeah.
I mean, she's just so fun to watch going after that basketball.
Katie goes, the defensive rebounding is, you know, she's as good as we've had. I'd say her and probably, you know, T was awful.
Yeah.
She could clear it, but hers was because sometimes she'd just jump over everybody. But Katie goes really hard, and then she's so strong hands and forearm wise, just the when she gets a hold of it, she has it. And again, it's rebounding is just one of those things where you kind of just have to show up, and she always shows up. You never have to worry about that with her. She's going to show up and play hard.
Well, the Tigers got that win and, of course, lost to Central Missouri. Now gearing up for two toughies on the road, Pittsburgh State and Missouri Southern. The Gorillas, I don't know if they call them a surprise, but they're certainly having a great season. Southern was picked to win the conference. They're kind of backs against the wall to try to do that, but obviously still having a very good year. We'll take a preview look at the two games coming up this week. Tiger Talk is brought to you by BTI. They're your John Deere dealer. They've got locations in Buckland, Great Bend, Greensburg, Hoxie, Ness City, and Pratt. BTI, our family in partnership with your family, online at btiequip.com. More Tiger Talk next on the Tiger Sports Network, built by PwC.
Ready to discover something new? The next time you're in your car, tune your radio to 94.3 FM.
It's here.
It's Hayes' greatest hits.
Love it.
On 1400 KAYS and 94.3 FM.
Do you believe in love?
FM, KAYS. Go ahead, check us out.
Wagner has it left wing. Tried to go to a cutting Ruddle, but can't find her. Now she'll try to drive. She's guarded by Nelson. Kicks it out to Ruddle for a three. She knocked in another one. Emma Ruddle hits her third three-pointer. She has hit three threes now in four consecutive games. 42-34. Maybe Emma Ruddle can get the Tigers back. Boy, she has had that hot three-point hand as of late. Yeah, kind of was that little push the Tigers made to get back in the game on Saturday. And, boy, Emma has been good. Three threes in four straight games and shooting a high percentage and that consistency. That's kind of something that's been missing. I think that consistent three-point shooting, hopefully she's found it, because that obviously changes a lot when you just have that person who can do that.
Well, I don't know the last time I can think of somebody that's hit at least three in four straight games. Usually we have somebody make three or four and then they won't make one for a couple, you know. They're just not consistent, or they're not getting the shots, or something's haywire. But Emma has been pretty consistent with her three-point shooting.
That's been fun to watch. And just we've talked about it before, just her all-around game. We have not talked about it yet. You did have one senior honored before the game on Saturday. Clary Donica, I guess a relatively short-termer on your squad, the senior transfer from Central Oklahoma. But as we talked before the game on the broadcast Saturday, I mean, she's been the consummate teammate. And you can see she's just really having fun. And it's neat to have her parents down to I guess up for them to be here for senior day and honor her before the ball game on Saturday.
Well, they're just they're a classy family, and she's a classy kid that's really fit into our team. She's just really enjoying the year compared to what she's experienced at her other stops, and she appreciates everything that she's been able to see here, and likes the people, and everybody's been really kind to her, and so she's having a good year for us, just in the fact that she has fit in so well, and she's a good teammate, and you can count on her. She doesn't complain about a thing. She just goes about her business, and we are trying to, you know, we've got the paperwork in to try to get her another year. I don't know. We'll find out in April, late March, April, I think. And there's a chance. I'd say probably a 50-50 chance.
That's cool.
We'll have her back for another year, and I think she would probably even contribute more on the floor being with us another year, just as she gets accustomed to everything.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, it does take a little while to fit into a new system. All right, on the road the next three games, two this week, down to Pittsburgh Thursday, Missouri Southern Saturday. Obviously a challenging road trip. Pitt State having a great year, four conference losses. I don't know if they're a surprise, but I think probably exceeding what most people thought they would going in, and as you mentioned earlier, I mean, they they handed it to you the first go around. It's been a while since you've been a part of one of those. I'm sure it's obviously on the back of everyone's minds. And you could talk about revenge. You could talk about all those things. But got to figure out a way to slow them down, because offensively they're as good as it gets in the conference and maybe the region.
They have a lot of tough matchups. I mean, they play four guards, and they have a couple guards that are big enough that they can play at the four and guard the four. So make it very difficult. They can really take you off the dribble. They've got three or four kids that will just catch and shoot the three that shoot a pretty high percentage. So, you know, it's a tough matchup for us. We have to really be on our toes. And, you know, I think they would be considered probably the surprise of our conference. They're the only ones in that top six group. They were picked lower than everybody else. I think they were picked seventh, maybe. I think Emporia was picked above them. They were picked either seventh or eighth, and they've given some people fits. They've already beaten Southern twice. They've beaten us. They've really taken care of their business. So a dangerous team. They'll be, I guess it won't be senior night probably for them. It'll be that on Saturday. Yeah. So, but they'll be keyed up. They're better at home like most people are, and we'll have to play great to beat them.
And you have Southern Saturday. I thought you played really well. Obviously, you beat them, and they were kind of going through a little stretch there mid-season when you played them. And you know, they're picked to win it, and they've got five conference losses. So they're kind of like you. I mean, they're battling for their NCAA lives as well, trying to get a chance to get back in. So you're going to probably face a highly motivated team and get their best shot.
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying, like, right now, I don't know. I think this might be the first week that regional rankings come out, but I don't even know because I'm not on the committee anymore, and I don't talk to other coaches on the phone all the time.
Right.
I'm not into that. So, you know, right now it looks like, you know, between Pitt and us and Southern, probably only going to be one of us that get in this beautiful format that the Division II schools have in the country. But I would say we'd have a hard time getting more than four in. We'll get three at least, probably four, just because of the strength of schedules. But if something goofy doesn't happen, it looks like Nebraska, Kearney, and Mo West and Central Missouri probably look like they have a good chance to get in. And then, like I said, it's going to be a battle unless there's an upset in the conference tournament.
Well, that puts a lot of importance on this week, and hopefully your gals can play well. I mean, it's a lot of fun, and I guess, as we've said before, you've got the teams ahead of you need. Now just got to go out there and try to find a way to get those wins.
Well, like I told you the other night, our strength of schedule will not go down.
No.
It's already up there pretty high. So I always enjoy the Pittsburgh trip because my old college coach lives in Pittsburgh, so I get to see him most of the time when I go down there. So. And we've had some good success there as of late, and we usually play pretty well at Pitt. So.
Does he give you pointers when he catches up with you?
Nah, he's not like that. We just talk about who was on the team and what they're doing now and where everybody's at and things. We just reminisce.
Yeah, that's always a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Well, we appreciate it. Have a great week of practice, and I guess we'll see you down in southeast Kansas on Thursday night.
Okay, thanks, George.
There you go. Tony Hobson, coach of the Fort A State women. Again, they'll take on Pittsburgh State. 5:30 tip on Thursday, and then it is Missouri Southern on Saturday afternoon, and that is what? I think it's a 1:30 tip. Yeah,
yes,
it'll be a 1:30 tip from Joplin. It's day-to-day for me. Tiger Talk brought to you by Adams Brown, where they do more than just run numbers and file tax returns. They work hard to become strategic allies. Adams Brown, strategic allies and CPAs. Head men's coach Mark Johnson next. This is Tiger Talk on the Tiger Sports Network, built by PwC.
That was another legend on 99 KZ Country. And yes, before that, we had a brand new artist. Your home for today's stars and the legends. We play real country. I'm Teresa Trapp. Weather, news, sports, it's all here. We're on Facebook, and there is a Listen Live link at KZPost.com. Dial us in on your radio at 99.5 FM. KHAZ, real country. 99 KZ Country.
Inbound to Hammocky. Caleb spins a fadeaway. He hit it! And the Tigers win! Caleb Hammocky hit the left corner three over a double team. Now they will go and check it. Some fans.
Pull off a huge win.
Well,
Well, here's the other thing, Gerard. I don't think there's any doubt that it counted, but did it go through with time remaining on the clock?
Yeah, quite a shot from Caleb. Tigers get the win over Lincoln on Thursday night, then backed it up with a hard-fought win over Central Missouri. Welcome back to Tiger Talk. We're live at Big Smoke Barbecue and Hayes, corner of 8th and Main. If you can't join us for lunch, get it to go. Get it for carry out for supper tonight, BigSmokeHayes.com. Of course, have all the ice cream treats, the soda fountain drinks as well. Best barbecue in town, their own special dry rub, choice of different sauces, the KC, the Texas, the Carolina. They've got it all here at Big Smoke Barbecue. Burnt ends and mac and cheese, just saying. It's been hard to deviate from that every week. It's been one of our favorites. I know Coach, I think, is going to do that again today as well. Tiger Talk brought to you by the Hayes Orthopedic Institute. Expertise, technology, compassion. It's all right here. Hayes Orthopedic Institute. They're the official team physicians for Fort Hays State Athletics. Well, let's just start with the shot. One of the all-time great game-winning shots. And you don't get in those situations very often. It's the first game-winning last-second shot, I think, since Rob Davis up in Sioux Falls back in 16. But you go back and watch that play. It's remarkable. It had zero business going in, and Lincoln defended it, I mean, about as well as you could defend without fouling him. And, boy, give Caleb credit. He found a way to knock that thing home.
Yeah, you know, and especially in today's world, it's even getting harder because now they go back and review. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So it seems like they're putting .3, .4, whatever. So very rarely do you now go where it's zeros when you make the shot. And so it's always good to be on that end of it when you make it and win the game. And, yeah, Caleb, you know, there wasn't much time. We just had to get the ball to the guy that has the best chance of creating his own shot. Obviously, for us, that's Caleb, and just ran him off a screen. I thought Lincoln defended it as well as you can defend it, and sometimes really good offense just beats really good defense. And not only, you know, he didn't panic, he took enough time. Sometimes, you know, try to tell your players for every second you feel like you have one dribble. You know, if there's 3 seconds, you're telling your guys, hey, you can take 3 dribbles and get that off. And, he didn't panic. And then what made it even harder for a left-handed person, he spun the other way,
yeah,
which makes it hard to make it, and just an incredible shot, by a guy that he's really come up clutch for us late in the games for the most part. This year, you look at the Kearney game, I know it wasn't a buzzer beater, but it was with 5 seconds to go.
Close.
And that's what you have to have. I mean, your players have to make plays at the end to win games. You're not going to draw up uncontested layups or wide open threes because the defense is locked in too. They're going to play, most likely the best possession of defense. They're going to play that whole game in that moment. And so you can't, like I said, you're not going to get something that's just really wide open. A player's got to make plays, and you got to have players good enough to do that.
Yeah, I think he scored the last 7 for you when the game was in the balance. He hit a big 3-pointer to put you up 4. He got a layup to break the tie, and then obviously hit the game winner. I mean, he came up clutch. And I know for the folks that were there, it was a great crowd. I mean, Lincoln's really good. I mean, Stapleton, they got some guys who can shoot the 3, and you did a good job of kind of taking that away from them. And then we know about the rebounding and their size. I mean, that's just they got all the components to be really good, and they proved that they are.
Yeah, no, they're a good team. Like I said, they got a shooter to complement the Stapleton kid, who I thought we guarded pretty well, and he had 19 points and 10 rebounds. And then Cy Witt, luckily Coney was in a little bit of foul trouble. I looked the next night against Kearney, I think he had 21 rebounds in that. So they're a hard matchup. You know, we just couldn't keep them off the glass. You know, you look at this year's team, you know, I think we're better defensively than a year ago. We just don't quite defensive rebound to the level a year ago. You look, we didn't have Jared. You know, Jared cleaned that glass. But we're really probably a better defensive team. You look at our field goal percentage is just a little bit – defense is a little bit not quite as good. A lot of that has to be just second-chance point putbacks. We can't clear the glass quite to the level of a year ago. But I think we're guarding extremely well right now, both games this weekend, and made it hard on everybody. Just would like to be able to get a rebound a little bit better. But, you know, I wouldn't say we're great rebounders. So, like we said, going to that game against Lincoln, you just got to survive. We probably didn't do quite as good enough job as we would have liked, but still we did enough to win.
Yeah, they scored 22 second-chance points. which was pretty big in a game. They score 57. I thought you did a good job on Routins, though. He's a good three-point shooter. You made him go 0-5 because when that component's working for them, they're tough to beat.
Yeah, I mean, you look at they're one of the bottom teams in three-point field goal percentage. I mean, the Knights, they're hitting perimeter shots, so you let him, the number 15, who is a good shooter, mm-hmm. you let him get loose. Now that takes them to the next level, and we did a good job on him and prevented that from happening.
Well, the Tigers found a way to get the win, and then you came back and played well against Central. That had to be just the physically, obviously, a game like that, but just the mental draining to come back. How do you handle practices on Friday? Because I know it's prep. You got to get ready for the next game. But after a game like that, I would just think everybody. I was spent on Friday.
Right.
It's got to go around for everybody.
Yeah, I mean, Friday's very, especially for this group the last 2 years. I mean, it does, you know. Like I tell our guys all the time, the good and bad about us the last 2 years is if you want to look at the negative, we have to show up and give our best physically and mentally every game to beat the team in first place or to beat the team in the 14th place. The positive about that is how we play and what those guys do. We're able to beat anybody we play. So there's that side of it too. But for us, yeah, we got to rest because we got to be locked in, ready to go, all out effort for a Central Missouri team in the time that was 7-10. But there's not a whole lot of disparity between us and them, you know. And our guys are really good, especially Gabe was pretty banged up with his ankle. So we're very light. We get some shooting up, maybe briefly dummy some of the things offensively we need to clean up. Don't very long. And then we basically just walk through what the team on Saturday is going to run and kind of a few things we need to be focused on. You know, we don't get too involved with the other team in the fact that we feel like what we do in practice guards 90% of what you do. But we try to spend time on either what you run the most or what we think may give us the most problems. Other than that, we keep it very simple, more worry about what we're supposed to do with our assignments on defense. I think you can get too consumed with the other team and then you forget what you're supposed to do. And there's just too much information, you know, paralysis by analysis. And we really do a good job of focusing on what we do, and our guys get really good at what we do.
Well, the Tigers did a good job in getting ready for Central Missouri. Hard-fought game with the Mules. We'll talk about that, and we'll preview this week on the road at Pitt and then at Missouri Southern. Tiger Talk is brought to you by the Taco Shop. You can order by phone. Use our handy app. It's awesome. Pick up, delivery, or dine in, carry out, 722 East 8th. The Taco Shop, it's been a Hayes tradition since 1970. You've never had it so good. More Tiger Talk with Mark Johnson after the timeout here on the Tiger Sports Network, built by PwC. The Tiger shot clock. Hamicky down the lane. Kick out to Yanchin. Another three. Yes, sir. Three in a row for Yanchin. Timeout Mules. Three straight Yanchin threes, and the Tigers have their big lead at 24-15. They're up by nine. Yeah, that was a 9-0 Biotne Yanchin run on three straight threes. Tigers were tied and then eventually built a 10-point lead in the first half Saturday, knocking off the Mules of Central Missouri 60-51. I think he scored 11 of 13, something like that during that stretch. And you go back and look at the game, that was kind of the deciding factor. You're able just to hold them off the rest of the way. But that was quite something. We've talked about his three-point shooting and he just got on a roll, and that was fun, and that was huge, very critical as well.
Yeah, I mean, he shot the ball great this year. I think he's over 50% mm-hmm. from the year, which is not easy to do, and it's amazing what the three-point shot does for you. You know, it was a 15 all,
yep.
And he just goes three in a row, bang, 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 and now all of a sudden you're up 24-15. It just gives you separation. You know, he's growing, he's gaining confidence, obviously, in that shot, but it's really, you know, has really elevated his game from the last year or two. You know, I think last year he was – the last 2 years he averaged 3.5 points, maybe as 2 years ago, 4 last year, and now he's up, I think, in conference at 10. Mm-hmm. He's been rebounding a little bit better as the season has gone on. And then, you know, we're not a great shooting team, so our guards probably don't shoot it as well as other teams, so it's important that you have someone in that other position that's shooting the ball right now as well as he is.
Yeah, 52.5%. He's 17-28 from 3 in the last 8 games, so quite a remarkable run. And he led Gen rebounding, 5 boards. And obviously, as we talked about with the Lincoln game, that's obviously critical. And he's got size and deceptive size, and that was good. He had one of his all-around great games, 5-7, 3-4-3, and then the 5 boards as well.
Yeah, and he's a great defender. I mean, he's A-plus on the other end of the floor. You'd like to see him consistently rebound better. And really, he, like we said, he has the last probably, you know, 3 to 3 weeks of the season. But then, like I said, it's nice when you're, you know, very rarely do you have a guy who shoots the ball as well as he does that is that kind of defender. Usually that doesn't really go hand in hand. You know, your shooter sometimes is your liability on defense, and he's a big strength of ours on defense.
No doubt, that was critical, and I thought it was a gritty win. I mean, you could tell Central Missouri, they're playing for their postseason lives to try to get into the tournament. Looks like there's kind of 3 teams going for 2 spots, and I thought they came out in the second half and defended as well as I've seen them defend, and I mean, they got after it, made you work, but I thought you guys answered that challenge and that call.
Yeah, I mean, really the second half, a little bit what we're going to have to do a good job of this Thursday is, you know, they don't shoot necessarily a tremendous percentage from 3, but they make quite a bit at times. Mm-hmm. And when they make 3s with the Pinkley kid as their big guy who shoots the ball so well, that's when they become really dangerous. And they came out the second half and hit some 3s against us that got them right back in the game. And I thought from that point on, maybe the last 15 minutes, we really clamped down. And I don't know if they really made another 3 at that moment. It was, you know, I felt bad for our bigs. You know, you look at Gilbert and Ian, it's their senior night. It's our last time to play at Gross. It was just a difficult matchup. We had to go small, and B and Trey had to step up and guard their big guys just because the way they shoot the ball and the Chapman kid on the perimeter driving, it was a hard matchup. But I thought we did a really good job. We finally, the first half, we kind of got away with it. The second half, they exploited us, and we had to go small the remainder of the game. And those guys, when we went small, did a good job defending the 3.
Well, you mentioned senior night. I know we talked about him a little bit last week, but it was neat to honor him before the ball game. And Ian's mom here, that was a cool touch, and it was still a nice little ceremony for those 5 playing their final game of the Coliseum. And it's always nice, and you know, there's a lot of pressure to try to get those guys a win, but it's always nice when your last game at beautiful Gross Memorial Coliseum ends in a W.
Yeah, for sure. And you know, because like I said, things emotions run high at times, and you just, it's a good thing or a bad thing. You never know how it's going to, each individual is a little bit different. But yeah, glad we played well, glad those guys were able to get in, and glad all 5, you know, one was from the Netherlands, one was from West Virginia, obviously Gabe, Gilbert, and Devin are Kansas kids, but it was nice that Jeff and Ian's family could be there with them on senior night, and it was really good, like you said, that we got the win, and I thought we played hard, and it was just a nice evening for sure.
I thought to see Jeff hit in a nice 3 in the game on Thursday night against Lincoln at a crucial time in the first half, and he hasn't played a lot, but when he gets in there, just plays so hard and just does the right things, and has been a nice contributor for you here this season.
No question. I say, Jeff's one of my favorite people I've ever coached. He's a hard worker. He's tough. He great personality. Selfless. Would never give you any. He's a senior. He wants to play more. Would never let that affect his personality or what's best for the team or anything. And it was really good to see him shoot. He needs to be ready going forward. You know, what's happened to him, obviously B just has to be out there. B1, he's shooting the ball great, but like B and Gabe just defend. They have to be out there. And then I think what turned a little bit, Trey has really elevated his game here the second half of the season. So it's, you know, Trey has to be out there quite a bit. So really more, not anything necessarily he's done bad, more those guys have done really well and has put him in a tough spot. But it continues to work every day and be a great teammate.
And he's got a great beard. I mean, there's some guys with good beards in the conference. I think Jeff may – he may have them all beat. For a guy who can't really grow one, I'm pretty jealous.
Right there with you.
It looks good. You mentioned Trey. I mean, he hit some big baskets down the stretch on Saturday. And you said just he gets a knack of getting to the rim, and he was finishing him. And he was really crucial in closing that game out.
For sure. I mean, Trey, like we're talking about, he's got courage, man. He's confident in himself, and the moment is not going to – you know, he's not going to panic in the moment. And, you know, really, whether it be a year ago, 2 years ago, really the first month of the season, I don't think our first thought was we got to get the ball to Trey to close out a game. You know, that's not a knock on him. That's how far he's come. But really, obviously Caleb kind of closed the game for us Thursday. You know, we were trying to go to Trey there late in the game two or three times, and he came through for us, and he just kind of has that knack to find a way to get a look off and get to the rim on a guy that maybe you feel like athletically he shouldn't be able to get to, or step up and make a really important three-pointer that he's pretty selective with his three-point shot. But he's really, without him stepping up and playing at the level he's been doing the second half of the season, we wouldn't have the record we have.
Did notice Jaheim Holden is no longer in a boot and it is walking a little bit better. Any update on his status, his progression?
Yeah, you know, he's out of the boot. I mean, it's all comes down, I believe it's Tuesday. Next Tuesday he gets hopefully his final x-ray. And if that comes back clean and good, he will be released after that. You know, how much do you – you know, that's going to be the question. Guy been out this long, maybe he can practice 2 or 3 days, and you put him out there in an important moment. I don't know if that's fair to him or anybody. So we'll just have to play it out. But hopefully on Tuesday he'll get good news and be released, and then we can make decisions from there. I think Lucas has done a nice job in his absence and done well for us, and we'll just have to figure out as we get to that point, you know, where his health is and what's best for our team moving forward. But hopefully for him, for sure, comes back. Like I said, I believe it's next week on Tuesday, and he gets good news.
Well, Tiger Basketball, Tiger Talk, brought to you in part by the Hayes Orthopedic Institute. Expertise, technology, compassion, all right here. You can regain your best moves. No need to travel far with the Hayes Orthopedic Institute. We will take our final break. We'll preview, well, two road games this week, down to the final 2 weeks of the season, at Pitt State and at Missouri Southern. That's up next for the Tigers, and that's up next for us here on the Tiger Sports Network, built by PwC. Fort-A State has it up by one. 10:20 to go in a game. Pischel open, shoots a three. Swish! He there buried it. 8 for Gabe. 42-38. Gabe Pischel with a big three, and the Tigers are up by four.
Yeah, I don't think they let Central get any closer than three the rest of the way after that one, and they go on to win that ball game. Now the Tigers gear up for the final three games of the season. They'll be on the road starting Thursday in Pittsburgh against Pittsburgh State, Saturday afternoon in Joplin against Missouri Southern. You played probably one of your better games of the year the first time you played Pittsburgh State. And just looking at some of their numbers, I mean, you can see, especially offensively, they've improved a lot since you played them the first go-around. And it's on the road. It's in Pittsburgh. This will be a much tougher game than I think people may expect just because of how bad you beat them the first time. But you're not going to expect to shoot the ball and play the way you did that game every time out.
Yeah, we played one of our best games of the year against Pitt. Shot the ball well, which is critical, obviously. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, they're a talented team. Like I go back to, I know their record, but like I said, in our league, the parity and all that, I think their average margin per game is 9 points. Yeah. So, I mean, it's roughly, if you want to count all threes, that's a three-possession game. And that's how fine line you have from being barely winning, barely losing. The other night, they hit 17 threes their last game out. They lead the league in three-pointers made per game. And anytime a team makes 10 or more three-pointers, I don't care what they're – that's a hard game to win that night. So we have to be really ready to do that. And they're kind of that dangerous team right now in the fact it goes one of two ways for them. You don't know what you're going to face in the fact that they're not going to make the conference tournament. They're down to their last 2 weeks of the season. So we're playing for a lot more than them. So maybe they won't be ready to play. But if they're on the other side of it, sometimes when you have nothing to play for is when you play your best. And I think they did that the other night when they made 17 threes. You're loose. You're relaxed. You're not necessarily concerned with the consequences. You know, our guys understand how important these games are to us. You come down, you miss a shot, you turn it over. That affects you going down to the next possession. So dangerous, dangerous game. And this is a game to close up if we want to continue to do good things. A game we have to win, and it will not be easy, though.
And then Southern, I mean, they've been kind of maybe the most head-scratching team, because when we saw them at Hayes, man, very impressed. They've got some big wins. They've got some head-scratching losses. But a team that's right there with you in those conference standings, you try to get at least a first-round bye in the tournament. Very talented, very athletic team. An equally tough task on Saturday.
For sure. You know, I think 1 through 6 or 7, they're as talented as anybody in the league. That's including Northwest Missouri yeah. and in Central Oklahoma. They've kind of, like you said, they've really played they've played their conference season a little bit like games happen, you know, spurts. They've had a great stretch of games where they're just unbelievable, then where they've struggled, and then back to being unbelievable again, and then struggle. So, but on their home floor coming, they're playing for a lot too. So they shoot the ball well. They got two big guys inside. And at our place, I thought they guarded extremely well. And they're long and athletic. They make it hard to finish at the rim. So you got to shoot. You got to make some jump shots against them. So be a tough road trip all the way around. We've been a pretty solid team on the road this year in conference play. And we're going to have to be pretty good this week to continue to have success.
But as we talked off air before this last segment, I mean, you got a chance if you have a great finish here to be in the regional picture, or you might be playing in the opening round of the conference tournament and not get a bye. It's crazy.
Yeah, it is. It really is. I mean, this season can still go a lot of different ways. We have not earned our right to Friday, and yet we could still make the regional without having to win the conference tournament if we finish strong. So just got to take it one, like the old coaching adage, one game at a time.
Sounds good, Mark. Appreciate it. We'll see you down in Pittsburgh on Thursday night.
All right, thanks, Rick.
There you go, Mark Johnson, coach of the Tigers. Again, Thursday night, Fort A-State at Pitt State. Women at 5:30. Men followed around 7:30. We're on the air at 5:05. And then Saturday afternoon in Joplin to take on Missouri Southern. That's a 1:30, 3:30 doubleheader. We'll be on the air at 1:05. Tiger Talk brought to you by Golden Bell Bank of Hayes and Ellis. Adams Brown, The Taco Shop, BTI, the Hayes Orthopedic Institute, and, of course, the fine folks here at Big Smoke Barbecue, the corner of 8th and Main in Hayes. BigSmokeHayes.com to go. Big Smoke Barbecue, the home of Tiger Talk. See you next week, everyone.